Hello, YouTubers. Hey, I had a, I don't know if it's a request or, I had some PMs about my steel, what I use for target stands. And this is pretty much what I use. I took that shepherd hook and cut it off and picked this rebar up. All the rebar, everything, just, it was pretty much free. And welded it to it. And down on the bottom, you may see better there, I had some other little square rebar and welded it there to keep it from moving, you know, side to side, and just help stabilize it when it's in the ground. And yeah, he's going crazy. And then that way you can drive them in right here. Just makes it a whole lot easier if you want to move them. You know, because as you know, them shepherd hooks, they're kind of a pain to work with. You can't drive them. You got no way to drive them in the ground. And then you got to try to get something to hold them up in the back and wire it. And just, I don't know, too much for me. Because you see this, I've not used shot this tombstone. Yeah, that weighs 34 pounds. You can see it's working out pretty well. And then these other ones, that's that one and that one. This steel came from Artisan Targets. They're the cheapest I've found online. That'll be the only place I'll buy my steel, and they got excellent customer service. So if you're thinking about steel, check out Artisan. I know you can't beat their prices. And if you've seen in my videos, I've shot this steel with 308s. Pretty much hammered it pretty well. And you see there's no craters or anything in it. So it's pretty good steel. And pretty much that's how I do my target stands. And then I took the leftover part of the shepherd hook and I welded this piece here on it. And I figured I can use that to, if I want to set drinks on it or shoot milk jugs or water jugs off of it. I got a little platform to stand them on. But there you have it. I appreciate y'all watching. I'm done.